Morning. So Bitcoin just hit a new record. There's not much else to say or talk about this morning. It's both been a long wait and a very short time relative to any other tradable asset out there. Since the Bitcoin white paper in late 2008 and then the first transactions in early 2009, the digital currency has been rising at an insane pace and with a lot of volatility. So we rose to 19,511 in 2017, then trended down in dramatic fashion to 3K, and then back to 14K, and then back down to 4 or 5Ks, only to now rally back to the 19Ks and touch upon 19,857. Unsurprisingly, 100% of the circulating Bitcoin supply is now in profit. It's been a wild ride, but we're now in a zone of unexplored prices and an investor base also that's very different from before, and that's important to understand. The number of institutions commenting and actually allocating funds to cryptocurrencies this year alone truly astounds me, and it's just the beginning, of course. When other institutions see competitors diving into the space and profiting, the temptation, I suspect, will be too much to handle. It's also worth noting that alts benefited as well, and in some cases actually outperformed Bitcoin. On the day, Ethereum is up 6.2%, Link closed the day plus 7.8%, BSV is up 8.2%, and then Litecoin rose about 10% yesterday. So what are the fundamentals that pushed the crypto space to these heights? On a longer term basis, the monetary policies by central banks and the institutional interest, obviously, those have been the theme. But on a short term basis, there was a massive news over the weekend of Guggenheim SEC filing amendment to invest in Bitcoin. And now just yesterday, AllianceBernstein saying that Bitcoin has a role in the investor's portfolio. So the name of the firm changes, but the story and the dynamic has been the same throughout the year with funds looking at Bitcoin. On a last note, I was talking to a colleague this morning and he said it doesn't even feel like there's been that much news or enthusiasm about it compared to 2017. And that's the beauty of it. There hasn't. Imagine what will happen when that enthusiasm, that media coverage actually comes in. That's all for me today. I wish you a great day and a great trading day.